Prayer, we should be quiet, Reverend.
We'll take 15 seconds.
Heads bowed, eyes closed. And as you pray, please reflect on every single word of our prayer. Father, you've created me in your image and likeness. I have come from you and I am ordained to you. Watch over me. Inspire me to choose good and to avoid evil. Allow me the sensitivity to see the needs of my neighbor and the strength to respond gently. Give me the courage to follow the truth and the grace to know you, love you, and serve you. Amen. Please remain standing, stand at attention. We now call on the school's choir, who will lead us in the singing of our national anthem. Choir, you will remain on stage after the anthem and will all remain standing for the praise and worship session.
And it's on the copy. Let me go to computer screen.
Yeah. And see if you can. Right. Is there?
The angel bowed before him, heaven and earth adore him. Jesus, oh, he's the King. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. The angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, let us praise the Lord, like a father Abraham, and his son, and his son.
I already sweat in the thought. Don't try that. Go try it, you're ready to what?
Ancestor is in Finchops. What we'll see about that, Ancestor, that's an Amazonian. Welcome. Good morning, Mr. Hamlin.
Good morning.
It's a pleasure being here with you this morning. It's our first experience, and I'm loving it.
I'm loving it too.
Yes.
Relax yourself.
And now we call on our dancers. Are they ready? CTSS Dance Club, Theatre Club. And we want to congratulate the dancers, the CTSS dancers, who this year actually won. Did you know that? They won at the National Dance Festival. And this is a big thing for CTSS. Come on, under the guidance of Ms. Iva Sackney and Mrs. Razan Alexander, our girls were able to pull it off. And we encourage them to continue in the arts, continue building themselves through the arts, and continue to make themselves and their school proud. So with no further ado, we call on the CCSS Theatre/Dance Club.
Give them a round of applause as they enter.
In a world filled with chaos, where we strive to survive, to provide, to find focus, we are met with melodies which bind us as families, melodies which bring us back to our roots, to our culture, our identity as one community. In the symphony of chaos, we find our song, a beacon of hope to where we belong.
Thank you.
deserves another round of applause. Make some noise for him. That performance is a very strong one. That's performance. And a number of our cheerleaders were there as well. What I also admire about our dancers is that a lot of them are also very academic students. One of my top students was actually there dancing. Let me tell you, she can dance.
She has some talent.
She has all the talent.
As you come on, I'm standing next to you, we have talent.
Don't sorry.
None of our students, right?
No.
And now you know.
Even the eyes of it, it looks to kill me, so they've already taken me out already.
That's right. Now at this time, we should have had our Minister of Education, Honorable Sean Edward, with us. However, he had to return for Parliament. So on his behalf, I'm apologizing, and hopefully he should be with us before the ceremony has ended. So at this point, we're going to jump down on the program to our awards presentation, which is what we are actually here for. Ah, how could I forget? You didn't remind me. How could we forget our dear beloved principal with her welcome remarks?
Yes, that's all right.
I think it's just...
Let's make some noise for Miss Daniela!
Sister Fess, I feel like taking off my shoes. I feel like taking up. Can I have some of that music?
Oh, teach them what?
Some of that music? Mr. Darcy, you know that song I really like. Leave me alone. And even without the music, I think all of you should stand. All of you should stand. As we do this warm welcome, we were supposed to very important song at the church. And I think we'd be remiss of me not to just retract a bit. And we're just gonna do the chorus to this. Alright? I'll put my own little thing to it. Yeah? Just watch me. We're gonna knock our hands together, which symbolizes the need for us to bring together our core. Our core, which means that we're coming forward with all of what we are. Yeah? We're knocking it together. We're rolling because we're gonna walk together. And we cannot do it without Him, our God. Yeah? So let's do that. 1, 2, 3. Roll it together. Up. And I'm just singing because Mr. Darcy can't get it yet. Let's go. 2, 3, 4. I am a very big God. A very big God. Oh, He always on my side. He always on my side. A very big God. Let's try it again. Waka waka when it came in. Yeah? So the people were asking where I got my moves. I actually was a member of Fado's group, cultural group, so I learned to dance. Anyway, the oldest task that I have is to do a welcome on behalf of so many people. Foremost is to congratulate you on behalf of Dame Lawrence, who is our first woman serving in the capacity as principal. As you well understand, Dame Lawrence is not well. She can't decide to move out unless the body says that she can. So wherever she is at now, she's watching, and I want the whole school to just say aloud and resounding, thank you, Dame. After three, two, three.
Thank you, Dame.
Thank you, Dame Lawrence. Everybody.
Thank you, Dame Lawrence.
And that's important. Mrs. Sanchez, the man would have been teaching you in EDC the history of our school. And so you would know that this formidable woman was quite instrumental in the foundation of CCSS when this idea was crystallized. And so she was part of the local team. And we cannot have an anniversary without Dame Lawrence present, but she is in spirit. So let's give her three chairs. Hibbert? 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 Yes, she deserves more, but for now that's all we need. Honorable Minister, as you know, the budget has started, annual budget. Our Minister of Education takes time out of his busy schedule to visit his schools. And CCSS is one of his favorite places to stop at. He never tells us when he's coming. He was here this morning, and of course he made sure that he had added value moments and engagements with us. So I welcome you to a school where we, as a school community, we have tentacles all over. Persons who have grabbed and enveloped us in their sphere of engagement to add value. So wherever sir is, he has the link. Let's say thank you, sir, Honorable Edward. Thank you, sir, Honorable Edward. Thank you. The second person who I've just mentioned is also very excited about the vibe happening at CCSS. And he communicates that all the time. So I welcome you to a school that is very supported by our supervisors and ministry. Mrs. Innocent, our DO, she went down to Supra yesterday for the district, inter-district primary sports meet and returned home very, very unwell. So she couldn't even report to the work this morning. So that's why she couldn't be here with us this morning. And of course, we call him our godfather, Honorable Stevenson King. He, as parliamentary rep, always attends and is very interested in what happens at all of the district schools, but more so CCSS. He calls me his favorite principal, actually. But I'm sure he says that to all the principals in the district. So that's okay, all right? But we would like to say thank you, sir. He too, over the years, has championed our cause and continues to do so. And we have some nice news coming to the business department very soon, amalgamated are the efforts of our parliamentary rep and our past student who is going to do some serious work to the business block to allow our business teachers to be more comfortable. So in his absence, let's give him a resounding round of applause. Okay? Some of you may not know it. I may not look it. As your principal, I'm very privileged to still be here and very proud today to know that what we started 33 years ago, when I returned to CCSS in 91 after Teachers College, Nicholas Eugene is here, she'll remember. We started this activity. Mr. Joseph's mandate to us as the small committee called the Awards Committee was to identify the efforts of students both in academia and non-academic areas. So let's give to our founding members who are not all here. I think Miss was on the committee at some point too. All right, let's give them a resounding round of applause for this idea. You were proud, students. Some of you are not always academically inclined, but you do work hard. So give yourselves a round of applause. Alumni, we are pioneers. So when they describe us and they talk and they malign and they say things about us, People steal our ideas. Alright? They copy our ideas. Alright? And that's okay. The original has to be proud when the clones do well. I always say that. Okay? So that's okay. We tribute and we salute everybody else. But award ceremonies, this thing started right here. And we did well. We recognize persons who are not our students, our staff, Ms. Maggie, you remember? We have done it. We did it in the 10 years when she spent her time here. And we looked at our ancillary staff. We looked at our corporate partners. So welcoming everyone to an institution where we recognize and do not disregard the efforts of anybody. I want this known. And yesterday at our dear beloved past student's funeral, Pastor Rene said so, and I want you to do this as I welcome you. Turn to the persons you are sitting next to and tell them I appreciate you and even so much how much you love them. Don't let the flowers wither. Don't let the flowers fade away. Don't let time rob you of this experience. Tell them how much you appreciate their engagement. Mr. Nassis, I appreciate your engagement and value to CCSS. Mr. Darcy, I appreciate your engagement and value to CCSS. Alright? And all of you students, on this Holy Thursday, let us be reconciled. In all of our engagement, let us be reconciled in all of what we do and think of the bigger picture. That we each have what it takes through these years of resilience to make this learning space the best for every single person. Not just for students, but for teachers, for parents. And when we would have failed, students, Kiara, when we would fail because we could, we are human, we will err, but because we take time to learn each other's hearts, we will know how to forgive. So I welcome you to a school who will not just stand resilient, but will also persevere to build each other. Thank you. Thank you, Rondell.
CCSS, guess what? Guess what? I love you. Thank you. At this point, we move on to our awards, which is what we're here for, to recognize excellence in every sense of the word. And to do that, we have Miss Janice Frederick, Head of Department for the English Department. Yes, hold some applause for Miss Frederick.
Round of applause for Miss Frederick.
I love you, Miss Frederick. Good morning, everyone. At this point, students, I'd like you to be extremely quiet. I would just like to echo one line from what Ms. Daniel said to you earlier on. She said, and I quote, "We recognize and acknowledge the efforts of everyone at CCSS." And I want to add as well, in a tangible way, as you will see this morning, and also in kind. This morning, students, some of you may feel discouraged.
Some of you may feel discouraged because you will not be receiving an award, but just remember that we acknowledge the efforts of all of you. Let me just give you a few words of encouragement. Some of you, and you know it too, especially as we close this term, some of you are lagging behind with some of your assignments, your projects, your SBAs, and these are the things that's going to deny you of that privilege of earning a tangible award. So let me just encourage you this morning, for those of you who may feel slighted that you are not going to receive an award, you've done well, but you can do better. You can do better, and I'm encouraging you to do better. And students, the information that we compile to reward you this morning, we collect that information for an entire academic year. So from first term, second term, and third term as well. So those of you who have not been doing just as well, the onus is on you right now to make that change. So at this point, we are going to award silver, gold merits, and department prizes. And we start off with the award of merit. And the award of merit goes to students who have passed all their subjects in terms 1, 2, and 3 of the last academic year. So if you've got a merit badge all 3 terms, you have qualified to receive an award of merit. And these students are from Form 1, Krista Bellamy. I hope I have pronounced the name correctly. Please come up. We had no student from Form 2 last year, no student. And it's not a case where we say you did not do well, but you would have had to succeed all your subjects to qualify. From Form 3, last academic year, we have Finella Albert. Congratulations. Merit badges, all 3 terms. And students, just a piece of information for you. The Form 5s who have left, they were there last academic year, but because they're gone, they're not part of the awards. Yes, so we acknowledge from Form 1 to Form 4. Form 4 now being in Form 5. And from Form 4, we would like to call on Stevenio Shabatis. So these are the students last academic year who succeeded all of their subjects, receiving merit badges, all 3 terms, Form 1, Form 3, and Form 4. So Form 2s, we need to break that uptrend, make a change, so that next year we could have Form 2s receiving silver merits. Stevenia Jabatis, are you there? Congratulations, students. Now we move to the award of achievement, the gold pin. So the award of achievement for students of Forms 1 and 2 with an overall average of 80% and above who qualify. So students, even if you have failed one subject, just one, or maybe even two, but your overall average is 80% and above, you qualify. And students of forms 3 and 4 with averages of 70% and above qualified as well. And these recipients are going to receive a gold pin and a certificate. So from Form 1, 80% and above overall average, we would like to call on Kiara Scopo and Sani St. Louis. Overall average of 80% and above. From Form 2, we only had one recipient qualifying, one student, in the name of Demika Romaya. Come up, Demika. Congratulations. Again, Form 2s, you have some work to do. You have to try much harder. You have to burst the sweat. You've got to burn the midnight oil as well. Form 3, and these recipients have received averages of 70% and above. Haley Hippolyte, come forward. Lydia Bailey. Well, proudly, students, come to receive your awards. You deserve it. You worked hard. Herman Charles. Kitani Ramjiwon. Brielle Axel. Alana Jules. Carissa Monrose. Frances Kashke, I hope I pronounced that correctly. Frances Sachike, thank you. Sarah Wilson, gold pins, 70% and above. Overall average of 70% and above. Jillian Romulus, Angel Vitalis, sorry, Saraya, there's a typo here. Saraya Wilson, yeah. Verona Vist, Cosma Siliga. Alyssa is not there, so he's proud that he will
team on his behalf. Come on, Mr. Simon. Diamond Lisa. Finella Albert. Daniel Isidro, have you received your pin? Serena Plummer. And Divine Jordan. These are the students from Compree with averages of 70% and above receiving a gold merit. And from Form 4, 70% and above, Stephenia Chabatis, Shade Pierre, Trinity Isa, Aidan Girao, Aidan, and last but by no means least, Andrew Henry. So these are the students from Form 4 last academic year. Congratulations to all of you students. Now we move on to the Department Awards of Excellence. And these students are going to be receiving trophies. And this Award of Excellence trophy is for the most outstanding student in each department. We have 8 departments at Catrice Comprehensive. These students have been very consistent, very persistent, disciplined, and not necessarily with the top grades. Yes, these students are going to be receiving a trophy and a certificate. In some cases, some of these students are pursuing 2 or more subjects in that department. So for example, science department, business department, pursuing 2 or more subjects that have qualified them for the department award. So we start with the business department. Good morning, everyone, again. We would just like to acknowledge the presence of our Deputy Chief Education Officer and my schoolmate as well, Teachers College. Yes, Mr. Cyrus Siva, students are coming. Okay, we move on to the Department Awards. And from the Business Department, we would like to call on Lydia Bailey of Form 3. And from Form 4, Stephenia Chabatis. And we're going in alphabetical order with the department. So we move on to the English department now. So the best Form 1 student, English language. And we are awarding these students both English A, which is English language, and English B, which is English literature. So for English A, Form 1, Krista Belloni. Best English A student at Form 2, Demeka Romeyer. Best English A student at Form 3 last academic year, Finella Albert. And Form 4, best English A student. Guess who? Steven Yershabatis. Still in the English department students, we now award the recipients for English B. So the best Form 1 English B student is none other than Aaliyah Etienne. Aaliyah. Form 2, Royalty Charles. From Form 3, Divine Jordan. And Form 4, Serona Tuse. Congratulations, English students, English A and B. We move on to the mathematics department, where some of you have difficulty adding the numbers. What would you say? It's not mathing at all, huh? Yes, so the best Form 1 math student is none other than Nisi Jimmy. Or is it Nisi Jimmy? Nisi. Form 2, Chancellor Darius. Form 3, well, I would have been disappointed if it wasn't, John I. Estefan. And Form 4, Marvin Faswa. These are the mathematicians. Congratulations again, math students. We move now to the modern language department where French, Spanish are being taught. And the best Form 1 modern language student is none other than Lishon Francis. Lishon. Form 2, Simon Mason. Come quickly, students. Form 3, Finella Abbott. Bless modern language students. And the best Form 4 modern language student, again she's absent, none other than Stevenia Shabatis. And students, from our observation, and history has taught us as well, that a lot of the students who are recipients of our internal awards, many of those students are the best students at graduation awards. Yes. All right, natural science is your turn, the natural science department. And in this department, a number of science subjects are taught. Integrated science, biology, physics, chemistry, and the science of the science teachers too. So, Miss Summer will proudly distribute those awards. She's also the head of the natural science department. So our best Form 1 natural science student is Leshawn Francis. Well, I just heard in the background that Daniel is at volleyball, is that correct? All right, so we'll acknowledge him when he does return. Our best natural science student of Form 3 is none other than Briel Asso. Briel Asso. And Form 4, Simon. Best natural science student. Yeah, these are the students who have to solve our problems with climate change. Yeah. Congratulations, science students. Yes, we continue with the alphabetical order. Thank you, Ms. Suma. We now move on to the social science department. And in this department, we also have a number of subjects being taught. We have history, geography, social studies, democratic citizenship as well, taught in that department. And we would like to call on Ms. Jongye. Ms. Jongye, yes, the head of the social department to deliver those awards. So our best Form 1 social science student. Come on, Aaliyah Etienne, you are the proud recipient. Aaliyah Etienne, come forward. Come here. Best social student from Form 2, Mia Theophane. Mia? Not here? From Form 3, Kitani Ramjiwan. And the best social student from Form 4, is none other than Trinity Isaac. Thank you very much, Ms. Jongye. We now move on to the technical department. We have two departments remaining, technical and vocational. But from the technical department, the best fourth grade student is Kayla Thomas. In the technical department, we have engineering drawing, mechanical engineering, technical drawing, electrical technology, building technology being taught as well. A number of technical subjects, auto mechanics as well. And from Form 4, Lindsay James. Lindsay James. Students, we don't have recipients for Forms 1 and 2 because at that point, you are simply given an orientation of what each technical subject entails. So the qualification starts from Form 3. Is Lindsay here? All right, thank you very much, technical. And our final department, vocational. And in the vocational department, we have clothing, textiles, and fashion being taught. Food, nutrition, and health.
Visual arts. Visual arts.
And visual arts.
Music.
Visual arts,
music.
Arts, music. Visual arts, craft, and music education. Yeah. Oh, theater arts, dance, and drama. Thank you very much. Yes. Yes, very important. So, yeah, so again, the qualifiers are coming from Form 3 and 4. Again, from 1 and 2, you simply got the exposure to those practicals. So from Form 3, our recipient qualifying as the best vocational student is none other than Finella Albert. Finella, start running. And from Form 4, the proud recipient here is Michaela Dennis. Michaela Dennis. Is Michaela here? Congratulations to all of you students. Silver merits, gold merits, as well as department awards. So we take a break at this time and hand you over to the Master Mistress of Ceremony.
Ms. Frederick, I'm so sorry to announce that you remain right here and we keep rolling with the awards because our dancers have gone on already. So we just need to continue on with the awards as we move on to special awards.
Students, at this point we move on to our special awards and we would like to reward students for their punctuality and regularity, and these students are going to be receiving pins this morning. These students come from each homeroom. They were most regular and punctual for school in the previous academic year. These students had never been late, never been absent. Yes, I think they deserve a big round of applause. So students, as soon as you hear your names, please come forward. So from 108, never been late, never been absent. Kiara Scopo, Kira Scopo, Tayshad Monroe, Sanik St. Louis, Leeshawn Francis, Haley St. Louis, Jada Setaj, Nicola Joseph, and Shanae Plummer. Congratulations. From 109, we only have one student who have never been late, never been absent, Jordan Mason. And we have no recipients from 110, 111, and 112. So students, you need to improve your regularity and your punctuality at school. Yes. From Form 2 to our 29, we have no students. None. To our 30, Joella Hyacinth, Brianna Masnett, Akela Thomas, Shawnette Valentine, and Simone Mason. Never been late, never been absent. We do not have any from 1231. And from 1232, Gordon John, Daniel Isdo, Leila Arsino, Gabriel Bugaran, Aaliyah McLaurence, Hidari, Anya Leo, Destiny Leos, Ariel Sylvester, Cruz Lubin, Chancellor Darius, Ulrich Odler, Kaelin Patfield, and Shadow Paul. All from 1232. Never been late, never been absent. We move on to Form 3 now, from Pre-Business, Nielsen William and Lydia Bailey. Pre-General, Urania Marcel and Verone August. Pre-Science, Alana Jules, Justin Gideon, Amy Phillips, Jalia Romulus, Frances Shashvi, Abigail James, Kylie Lewis, Javon Justin, and Saraya Wilson. Pre-technical, Queen of Constable, is that correct? Yeah. Jonah Estefan and Joel M. Alexander. And pre-vocational, Haley Hippolyte, Harmony Raymond, Jiva Constantine, Gillian Mafre, Adaisy Simon, Adansi, Zion St. Louis, and Tonisha Alsi. These are the four threes, never been late, never been absent. Perfect regularity and punctuality. And from the Form 4s, we start off with Four Business, Alia St. Martin and Charlie Pierre. Alia St. Martin, Charlie Pierre. For General Hasner. From Four Science, Vivian Caldwell. Malik Peter. Candice Alfred. Andrew Henry. Joel Paul. Simon Hillman. Kalana Edward. Liam Hippolyte. And Arthur Wells. For Science. Four technical seems to have the most lens. There is no technicality, irregularity, and punctuality there. So from four technical, Aiden Anthony, Fidel Kane, is that Shane Casabo?
Yeah.
Marvin Firstwell, Giovanni James, Lindsay James, Shoma James Nicholas, Colonel John, Taquan Lee, Ethan Dobrin, Rashid Masley, Valen Philip, Kidandre Prosper, Grace Joseph, and Teresha Joseph. That's four technical. And from four vocational, Khadija Alexander, Antonia Celestine, Michaela Dennis, Sienna Hart, Clement Henry, Nicola Joseph, Vanessa Joseph, Nerissa Louis, Michaela Olivier, Hanel Pierre, is that J.M. Plummer? J.M. Plummer, Julian Wells, Adere Aze, and Ethan Dupin. These students are proud recipients of 100% regularity and punctuality. Congratulations to all of you. And students, that's important for your workplace. Aisha Alexander, most improved from 1 out of 11 last year. And from 1 out of 12, Makeda Lionel. Are these students there? Okay, we move on to Form 2, most improved. So we didn't have any from 2 out of 29. From 2 out of 30, Brianna Maslin. Brianna Maslin. 2 out of 31, Sammy in the Cordial. And 2 out of 32, Anaya Joseph. From Form 3, most improved, 3 business, Marisa Sydney. From 3 general, we had none. 3 science, Kylie Louise. 3 technical, Asia Fanos, is that correct?
Asia.
Oh, Asia Fanos. And 3 vocational, a Dazzy Cycle. Most improved students. From Form 4, most improved for business, Naomi Adoma. We had none from 4 general. From 4 science, Liam Hippolyte. Most improved from 4 technical, Keandre Prosper. And most improved from 4 vocational, Aidan Girao. We move on now to the most disciplined students in each homeroom last year. And the recipients from Form 1, 1 out of 8, Lishon Francis. Okay. We would like to call on Pastor Sergis to assist in the distribution of these certificates. Thank you. So the most disciplined 1R8 student, that's academic year, Lisha Francis from 1R8, 1R9, Janelle Ferdinand, 1R10, Carissa Winnie, 1R11, LaDanian Phillips, and 1R12, Kellyanne Lawrence. Form 2, 2 out of 29, Mikaya Leos. 2 out of 30, Joella Hyacinth. 2 out of 31, Jeremy Wilson. And 2 out of 32, Daniel Isidore. From Form 3, Form 3 Business, Sadia Amado. Sorry about that. 3 general, Dante Alexander. Most disciplined, 3 science last academic year, Alexia Setage. Most disciplined, 3 technical student, Alyssa Simon. And most disciplined,
Alistair.
Daddy, most disciplined.
Alistair.
And 3 vocational, Haley Hippolyte. And from from 4 homerooms, most disciplined, 4 business, Stephenia Jabatis. She's out. 4 general, Tristan Joseph. 4 science, Vivian Caldwell. for technical Grace Joseph and for vocational Jared Solomon. Yes, now is the time. Engage in a sport, do something. You will be rewarded. Practice makes perfect, right? So we would like to call on the recipients for basketball, both male and female. And the female sports awardee is Michelle St. Mary. The junior male basketballer, Jaden Scotland, and senior male basketballer, Arthur Wells.
Arthur volleyball. Arthur volleyball.
They're not here?
Volleyball.
Alright, so we move on to track and field. And we're awarding both male and female. So the male track and field student here is none other than Nielsen Wilson. And our female sports star track and field is none other than Martin McKenzie. Our junior footballer, Joran Philip. Where are you, Joran Philip? And our senior footballer is none other than Thales Mondesi. For table tennis students, our male here awardee is Lishon Francis and female Safia Popo. Best table tennis players, male and female. Our junior cricketer, most outstanding junior cricketer, is Kaden Fosua, and our most outstanding senior cricketer is Kareem Francis. Our most outstanding junior netballer is Janet Ford. Janet, and our most outstanding senior netballer is Lana Hollingsey.
Volleyball, volleyball. Yeah, volleyball.
Our most outstanding volleyballer male is Arthur Wells, and our most outstanding female volleyballer is none other than Rishi Spencer. We also engage in chess. Well, students, and our most outstanding student is Tristan Joseph. The certificate is in here, but Tristan, just come forward, let us acknowledge you. Tristan Joseph? Yes? Right. Very good. So these are our sports awards students. At this point, I would like to congratulate again Form 4 Vocational for winning our elocution competition. And today we want to officially award you. So we have prepared a plaque for you and the pins as well. Yes, so we would like Form 4 Vocational, very quickly to come up. Quickly, students, Form 4 Vocational. As well. Where are you, Miss Bernard? And Mrs. Alexander? Rosanna Alexander? And for you, specially invited guests for meeting, the students had a poem that they had to present using their voice, a little drama to create an atmosphere. Among the four levels, 1 to 4, and 4 vocational English champions. So we have prepared a plan for them for Vocational Elocution 2024, and they get a pin that they keep as a memento as well. Both male and female. So what we traditionally know as first place in the homeroom, first place in class, yes, but it's per homeroom for the last academic year. So the top performer per homeroom, male and female, they each receive a gold medal and a certificate. So we started the Form 1, so 1 out of 8. Top performers, Lishon Francis and Kiara Scopo. We would like to call on our Deputy Chief Education Officer to do the honors for us. From 1 out of 9, Kimberly Anthony and Crystal Belloni. Top students, top performers in 1 out of 9, last academic year. From 1 out of 10, Sanjay Brown and Aaliyah Yam. Sanjay Brown and Aaliyah Yam.
Alicia.
1 out of 11, Nathaniel Phillips. And Nessie Jimmy, or Missy Jimmy. And from 1 out of 12, last academic year, the top performers were Gideon Louis and Corinne Noel. Congratulations. Form 1s. We now move to the Form 2s. So from 12 to 39, top performers were Amani Iturvin and Demika Romayo. From 12 to 30, Amani Iturvin. From 12 to 30, Karen Francis and Simon Mason. From 12 to 31, Antonio Valasquez and Mia Leopin. And 12 to 32, Daniel Isidore and Annalie Newton. From Form 3, 3 Business, top performing male and female, Nielsen William and Lydia Bailey. From 3 General, top performing male, Veron August and top performing is our female Curtis Antoine. From 3 Science, Nia Morio and Jalia Romulus. From 3 Technical, Alyssa Simon and Queen of Constable. And 3 Vocational, Fidela Albert and Jaden Alsey. from each homeroom, male and female, for Business alias St. Martin and Patty Abraham. From Form 4 General, Tristan Isidore and Trinity Isaac. From Form 4 Science, Aldrin Henry and Kalana Edward. Students, you need to walk with me. For Technical Marvin Fasua and Grace Joseph. And for Vocational, Michaela Dennis and Jared Solomon. So these are our top performing male and female in each homeroom, each form level. Thank you very much, Mr. Sipa. At this point, I would like to call on our master mistress of ceremony. One amendment here. It was an oversight. I think it was an error in the typo. The top performer for Fort General, we called Tristan Isidore, but it's Tristan Joseph. Yes, so the top performer for Fort General is Tristan Joseph and not Tristan Isidore. So my apologies. We have a special award that we would like to present to the technical department, and it's from class of 1988, and we would like to call on Mr. St. Luke's to receive that award on behalf of the technical department. I would like to call on Grace Phillips. If you are in the audience, please come forward. Grace Phillips. No? Chinese come forward. Form 4 students in the vocational department to come forward to receive this prize on behalf. Fenella Haley, come forward. Haley Nicolet. Will serve all of the subjects in the vocational department. The music, clothing, textiles and fashion, visual arts, theater arts, food, nutrition and health. Thank you very much. I now turn you on to the mistress of ceremony.
Thank you very much, Miss Frederick. Job well done. And now we're going to recognize some very special people of Castries Comprehensive. They have either served us very long or are still serving us. And we start off with Mrs. Noelis Edgar Lord. She's a past student from the class of 85. Joined the CCSS staff after completing her associate degree in agricultural science at South CC in 1994. She came in from Anglican Primary to teach agricultural science after she was approached by the then principal, Mr. Jeremy Joseph. She left in 1996 to complete her first degree in agribusiness management and returned in 1999. In essence, she has been employed at CCSS for 30 years. Though the challenges, she has had many wonderful experiences at the school. She was a teacher in charge of the Girl Guide troop for a number of years. She also spearheaded the quadrille dance troop and worked alongside Mr. Jules in the house pageants back in the days. She loves the idea of developing the whole child that the CCSS program aims to achieve. She has thoroughly enjoyed most of the moments at CCSS, from the success of students, to the relationship with staff and especially the energy of sports. We all know all too well that the sporting season is her favorite time of year. She has been the house mistress of Oriole House for many years now, and she's very thankful to God for the wisdom in handling the house and the success over the years. She has taught many subjects in addition to agricultural science, such as English, HFLE, RK, and of course, Integrated Science. She is hopeful that the biggest lesson that she has taught is not in the academics or the content of the subjects, but rather in being a good example in character. She has endeavored to always try her best to teach her students that they can do nothing without God, and hope that this is something they can take with them anywhere, anytime. Presently, she holds a Master's in Agricultural and Rural Development and is a teacher attached to the Science Department and serves as Assistant HOD. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Noelis Edgar Lord.
Thank you.
awarding. As it's noted, this evening embraces the dawn of 50 years, she not only reflects upon her entrance into the hallowed walls of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. As a student, it was a dream come true as she navigated through the classes etching her mark in history. And then, she said, I discovered my passion. A passion to be a nutritionist. Opportunity knocked on her door and she became a teacher at her alma mater. This fueled her aspirations as she had a vision for the school to have its own restaurant and garden that supplied foods that contribute to a healthy lifestyle. Educating students about food, nutrition, and health is the heartbeat of a nation as it produces healthy citizens and creates opportunities for self-employment and the blossoming of cottage industries or small businesses. To date, CCSS is proud of its exquisite cuisine, a restaurant service that exemplifies the skills that the students have mastered in the classroom. So she embarked on her journey of becoming a food technologist, modeling a behavior where her students aim for excellence in their studies. To date, her students have achieved 100% pass rate in CSEC exams, a feat that is totally achieved through dedication and hard work. They have also made their mark in competitions organized by local and regional organizations, which has contributed to their growth and development. As embedded in our school's anthem, the salutation of the dawn, it's a dawn that has given rise to local and international chefs. Our very own Nina Compton trained professionals in the tourism industry and business owners like Ilana Villene. The vision continues to blossom as she witnesses a sense of achievement in their studies and the joy of success in their eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Priscilla Cotra, 32 years of service to CCSS.
Unfortunately, Mrs. Cotra is not with us at this time. She's currently engaged in an industry activity for food and food preparation to the students, an activity jointly with the tourist board. And so, as a vice principal, I'll accept her.
almost 35 years ago, she began a long, challenging, yet fulfilling journey at the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. This road began with her job as one of the school's janitors, where, according to her, the salary was only $400 to $500 a month. But these hardships were no match for the ambition and drive in this little shabby lady with a good mouth, free spirit, an even bigger heart, and long, lovely black hair, as it was back in the day. She served for 11 years and two shifts as a janitor. These shifts were 6 to 10 in the morning and 2 to 6 in the afternoon. One day, while she was eating her food, a student asked her for some. It was so delicious that the student said, "Cook for us some." And thus began her second hustle. With permission, she began to sell delicious rotis and burgers to students between shifts and behind the huts, first from her basket and then her hand cooler. Soon after, she gave birth to the floaty, which began from extra chicken roti for which there was no shell and float. Yes, float and roti equals floaty. With God's help some years later, she secured the proprietorship of the school's canteen and has to this day fed generations of us. By now you know that we speak of none other than our very own. As we celebrate our 50th anniversary, we want to say thank Miss Maggie for all the floaties, float and cheese, for the bellies that you fill, the bus fares given, the patience during the break and lunch rushes, and for all of the love and kindness that you show to us daily. May the work of your hands always be blessed. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Marianne Cherry, Miss Maggie.
December 28th, 2024, when he celebrates his 63rd birthday.
And Mr. Clarence Joseph is unable to be with us now, but I would like to applaud Mr. Joseph in his absence. Thank you, Mr. Joseph. Clarence Joseph. Also unable to be with us today, we would like to recognize the long-serving past principal, Mr. Jeremy Joseph. He was an English teacher in the 1980s, served later as vice principal, and was instrumental in ensuring that the English department developed programs and platforms to showcase students and staff members' literary skills. He left us for a short stint at Camdu, but was summoned back to CCSS when Mr. Kays resigned for Trinidad and Tobago. Mr. Joseph assumed the role of school principal from 1986 to 2010. During his tenure, he was fondly remembered for encouraging many aspects of our school's culture. Example, rebranding the sports program in 2005, Cardinals, introduction of music, modern language room, and HSB to our syllabus. In his absence, we say thank you to a long-serving past principal, Mr. Jeremy Joseph. He too will be receiving a plaque and a small token, as well as Mr. Clarence Joseph. Here we have our beautiful.
Thank you very much, Ms. John. Let's put our hands for our awardees. And to celebrate our 50th anniversary, we would like to give flowers to all those who have deserved it. And so now I ask my dear teacher, homeroom teacher, she's now the director of counseling, Mrs. Joycelyn Nicholas Eugene. I stumble on that because I always call her Miss Eugene. Please join me on stage for the final presentation.
Good day, students. And good day to our invited guests. I have the awesome privilege to do this presentation. This presentation is going to be made to a colleague and friend. She started her stint at Castries Comprehensive in 1989. She entered as a business education teacher. And like me, she taught her students shorthand, typewriting, which is now EDPM, office procedures, which is now office administration. She is a very fun-loving individual and kept the business department lively with her jokes and hearty laughter. She was always ready to socialize and excited about fun times, such as taking us to her family land to look for mangoes and other refreshing fruits. She was always planning and participating in social activities. Nighttime social on the beach, parties, dinner on the weekends with people from the department as well. We had the awesome privilege of working with her, and we were and we still are her school family. She was always willing and ready to help. Lend a hand, give advice, support, and encouragement for whatever positive endeavors one tried to pursue. She is serious about education and has a deep interest in the well-being of all students. She had been our Red Cross coordinator. She was responsible for junior achievements among the students. She headed the business department and then proceeded to serve as vice principal. She was always ready to organize her religious activities. She also introduced uniforms to members of the business department. Ladies and gentlemen, this young lady has been a member or has served CCSS for 35 of its 50 years. And I know she endeavors to continue until, well, the time comes for her to make her departure. I have the honor and the special privilege of presenting to you a champion. Every child needs a champion. And Ms. Martha Gail Maxima Daniel is a champion. Students, can you stand and give her a round of applause?
Because the words simply mean how much we are grateful. Two, three. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you each day. We thank you, Lord, for your parents who to the years. As we grow through the years, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you. you each day. Our teachers, we thank you, Lord, for our teachers who taught us through the years. We thank you, Lord, for their patience as we glow through the years. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you each day. Our true friends, we thank you, Lord, for our true friends who love us through the years. We thank you, Lord, for their kindness as we struggle. For every gift you've given us, we thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. For every gift you've given us, we thank you each day. And this song was composed, words and music, by our dearly beloved retired teacher, Mr. Cuthbert Anselm, who taught English and French at CCSS. Let's give him a round of applause in his absence.
Thank you very much. You may take your seats now as we call on our Deputy Chief Education Officer, Mr. Sipon, to deliver his remarks.
Thank you very much. I will be very short, students, because I know you are hungry and then you have had a long time. Madam Principal, special invited guests, staff members, students, good afternoon, everybody. On behalf of the Chief, Ms. Diedoni, and the rest of school supervision, we just want to say thank you to what you have done CCSS for the past 50 years. And let me tell you, your principal, the school, and myself, we have something in common. We are in our 50s. we know what it is to be 50. We know what it is to celebrate 50. So which means, Castries Compre, you have left a legacy. And those who come after, we'll sing about that legacy, we'll talk about that legacy. And to have that great principal, listen to what I have written here. She's charismatic, dynamic, creative, vivacious. That is Miss Daniel. What better person now to take you to the next half century, Miss Daniel. And finally, I just want to tell you, Castries Compre, listen, I did some analysis of the mathematics results last year. I put all the schools around St. Lucia with reference to your pass rate, the ones, the twos, and the threes. And what I did, I went to get the scores of the common entrance 5 years ago. And I checked every child, what is it they came with to your school with mathematics? And what is it they are going out with? And Castries Compre, you did well. Put your hands together. You did well. So therefore, have it now. For the first 50 years, it was your character. That's what you were showing, your character. For the next 50 years now, listen to what we want you to show now. We want you to show the grit. The grit. What is the grit? We're talking about the strength of your character. Hear the difference now. The first 50 years was your character. Now the tire is going to hit the road. You're going to speak the language of the responsible. You will not speak the language of the victim. You're going to make sure that the ethos, the identity, the mantra of this school will resonate right throughout your being. And ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you something. Castries Compre will continue to be the mecca of all schools. And the Ministry of Education will continue to celebrate with you because you deserve it. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Sipon. And at this moment, we just want to take a short pause to call on Stephania Jabatis to receive all of her awards. At this point, Stephania, you got an award. You got an award of merit, award of achievement.
We felt it necessary. We know it's been a long time, you being in here, but I need you to put your hands together for our female volleyball team. We just beat Sufre. That's why. Yes, Miss Jongay. We started a tournament about a month ago, and Sufre was the first team we played, and they beat us. But we said they took such a long journey coming up. I said, children, you know, just let them win. So they beat us, yeah, we let them win. But today, we ensured that they did not think that CCSS was an easy feat. Okay, Mr. Stefan, as you said, a first-two record. Our team, we came up against St. Joseph's and St. Mary's day before, and it was such how do you say this? This match was quite a difficult one. They went into a draw and they had to play again, so much so that one of our players is right now injured and she couldn't play today. But our girls, in her tribute and on our anniversary, we said we're not leaving anything behind. And so we have now emerged out of the tournament, which ended today in the third position overall winners of this year's National Volleyball Competition. We still have one of our top players, yeah? So that's why we said, no, we cannot exclude, we have to include her.
So again, award of merit, the silver pin, award of achievement, gold pin. Best Business for Student Department Award. Most Disciplined for Business. Modern Language Award. English Department Award. A General Award. Wrote English in Form 4. And got a General Award, A Profiles. In Form 4. Wrote POE in January. And got a award. Congratulations, Stephania.
Good afternoon, everyone. For those of you who may not know me, I am Ms. Norman. On behalf of all students and staff, I am glad to be standing here to express my appreciation. A special thanks to our specially invited guests, including our past students, teachers, and parents for accepting our invitation and for being here with us today. Your presence here has truly made this event extraordinary. I would like to thank our principal, Ms. Daniel, for always supporting and guiding her staff and students. Our teachers, the superstars of today, always putting a lot of effort and love into making each one of our students into wonderful human beings. Our energetic, humorous, and enthusiastic MCs, we thank you for being the catalyst for this event. Our anniversary committee for organizing the events throughout this month, which have made 50 years at the school feel special. I would also like to thank each and every one of you for being here and making this day a wonderful and memorable one for our school. Thank you once again and happy Easter to everyone.
Thank you, Mrs. Classic Novel. Thank you, students. I know it's been a long morning. We're coming to the end We start with prayers and we're going to end with prayers. So please stand and I invite one of our RPA volunteers, long time, Pastor Lee Sedges, to lead us in prayer. But before Pastor Sedges does that, yesterday, I think in my old age of getting soft, I find myself so emotional that I had to leave the room. Yesterday, we laid to rest one of our students. I could imagine how his parents felt. No parent is supposed to bury their child. And no teacher or principal or vice principal should have to attend the funeral service of a student who graduated just last year. And every time I think about it, I get emotional. But I think it's fitting as we celebrate our 50th anniversary on this last day of school, this Holy Week, that we take a moment of silence to remember the little Duga, that gentle flower. Beginning now. Eternal rest grant to our Lord. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
Pastor Sedges.
It's been a long day. Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful, most holy Father in heaven, we give thanks to you for this day. In spite of the sad news we just heard, but we thank you. For today, we thank you for this wonderful institution that you have blessed us with, oh Father God, you have blessed St. Lucia with. Thank you, Father God, for everyone, from the principal to the staff, to the auxiliary staff, to everyone, every student, oh Father God, who is part of this institution. I pray, Father, that you let your blessings be upon this place, because it is a good place, it's a place to shape the minds, the hearts, the character of students. So I pray, Father God, that your blessings will be here and many wonderful things will continue to happen. May every student look forward to coming here to learn, Father God. May every teacher be prepared, Father God, to spend time to condition the hearts and the minds, the will, the character of the students, of God. Thank you for every student who have gone through these doors, Lord. They have become productive citizens, oh Father God. Let all be well with us as we leave here. Let your spirit go with us. And I pray above all that your spirit, the presence of your spirit, will be in this place, oh God, to guide, to direct, that all things will go well according to your will. And this place will continue to be a good place, will be known to be a very good place to be. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, everybody. Good night.
Amen. Thank you, Father. Pastor, sorry. School's anthem, we call on the school's choir. Students, you've been wonderful. Let's finish strong. A few members, we don't need the entire choir.
Strength on the fairy.
go to the Vice President. I will invite his team, Mr. Richard Jamari, Mr. Tamari Fisher. And all the others. We also invite the PTA and the reps and the Global Alumni Association represented by Mr. Glenn Simon. All of you come over as a representative group to cut the cake. Ms. Joyce Nicholas as all of our past teachers. Ms. Deborah Nicholas and all of our past HODs. Come on. And we have Mr. Sipa, our supervisors. Yes, and Miss Maggie, all of our class auxiliary staff, and Mr. Shobo Darcy, our current non-teaching staff. So we have a representative group of all of our stakeholders at CPSS. Thank you, thank you.
Students, stick around, you're also getting your cake as well.